This is the Microfire Excalibur H20. It is a fully focusable 1,000,000 CD flashlight. That gives it a range equal to the BLF GT at about half the size. Welcome back. Thank you to Microfire for sending me this light to review. Much appreciated. This Excalibur, it's an LED. That 1,000,000 candela range comes from that little itty bitty tiny dot inside the head. I like the build quality on this. This light is made to use. Very easy to find switch on the neck. I like a neck switch if I can find it, and this is a good one. The finish is good. It is a zoomy. The head comes in and out. And it's pretty solid. Very, very little movement in that. The seals on it are so good. Watch this. It's got a little vent there. The H20 comes with its own hard case. It does have an integrated battery pack and a tail plug charger. 75 watt hour battery pack. It feels really good and solid too. Let's have a look at our beam quality. At a wide angle, we've got just about perfect. Very vanilla color. I mean, just you can see in the very center, there's a couple of little tiny, little itty bitty dots, imperfections, but that's about it. Even edge to edge. And then as we zoom in, around the outside edges, we get kind of a yellowy gold. We're still real, real nice in the center, good color. Fiery orange on the outside, not a great blend. And then when we go all the way out, we turn like blue. Kind of zoomies always sort of have a little bit of that effect, but this one's kind of purple. I'm okay with it though. It still looks nice. It's a sharp spot. Let's talk performance. I looked in the instructions and on the website and everywhere, and I couldn't find anything where they had a lumen claim at all. They had the candela, but nothing about lumens. I went ahead and tested the light, and I got 297 lumens. Now, that might seem kind of low for a light this size, and the reason for that is because it is. it's not massive, but, I mean, it... The output is usable, and I really don't think they were going for high output. The upside is this is fully sustainable. There is no turbo timer or any temperature thing that I was able to find. You can turn this thing on and, like, just run it and come back whenever. I turned it on and left it and came back in a while, and by, like, a while, I mean... And when I did pick it back up, it was still at 275 lumens. In the instructions, Microfire stated that you could get 6.5 hours of runtime on that highest mode with this. I also tested the range, the candela. Their factory claim is 1,000,000, and I got 1,200,000 from mine. Now, the reason that they're able to pull that off in a light with a head this small is two things. Even though this LED is not super, super bright, it has very high surface brightness. It is a little guy. I mean little, little. And I don't even know what it is. They wouldn't tell me. I asked and they said, we're not going to tell you. And I've seen the LED one other time in another light, in another prototype that... We'll talk about some other day. that a company sent me, and I asked them to, and they weren't coming off of it either. They were just like, you know, I don't remember what they said, but they wouldn't tell me. So maybe you guys recognize this emitter, because I don't. Also, in addition to this emitter that I've never seen, they're doing something else I've never seen in a full-blown production light. Maybe some of you recognize this. For those of you that don't, if I'm not mistaken, that is a Wavian RLT collar, or maybe a clone that they made themselves. Either way, it looks to me like that they're using the light recycling technology. If you're not aware of how the light recycling technology works, it's basically this. The light from the LED is fired outward in kind of a wide pattern, and the collar is like a reflector that's flipped upside down. The light bounces off of the inside of that metallic surface, and it's redirected back toward the LED die, and then all of the light that would have been scattered outward bounces straight out the front of the light. And it doesn't add to the lumen factor, but it concentrates the light much more effectively. The one and only downside to this whole setup that I see is that even on the widest focus, we do get a pretty large beam, and it's nice, but it's not really that wide compared to my other zoomies that are a mile wide. Something else I noticed about this light is when you zoom out to where you've got the tight focus, you really don't lose that much output. With traditional zoomies, there's usually a massive drop. Here's our beam profile with no lens and no collar. Here it is with only the collar. And here it is with the collar and the lens. I noticed just now too, the lens is plastic, either polycarbonate or something similar. It's real lightweight. Tonight we'll begin with Acebeam W30. That is our white laser flashlight. Now let's see Microfire H20. Side by side, we'll keep Microfire on the left here. Acebeam's on the right. You know, I can tell a little difference in hot spot size. Acebeam's still got a little tighter spot. And for our water bounce test, Microfire on the left, Acebeam on the right. Okay, something I forgot. With the Microfire, the all the way zoomed out position gives us kind of that round shape, but backing it off a little bit gives us the tightest spot. It's sort of hard to see there, but it's actually square, just like our cheaper zoomy, and it does make the spot smaller. This is the Microfire, and then Acebeam W30 on the right now. So, really, this has got just a tiny bit smaller spot now. It is possible to get a perfect image of the die when we back it off a little. The camera bleeds it out quite a bit, but there's all the way out, and if we back off, we get our square. We'll go up close so you can see what we're really looking at here. Okay, on the camera here, that square there is actually not the die. It's the material around the outside of the die. It's a perfectly crisp image. If we turn down shutter speed or ISO enough. There we go. Now you can see what it really looks like. Those kind of darkish spots around the edges there, like where the writing on the outside of the LED platform is. So it does make a perfectly crisp image. Let's compare to our run-of-the-mill zoomie. Quite a bit wider with this. Sheds. More intense here for sure. It just kind of blots out the sheds, really. This one is not.
If you'd like to get your own Microfire Excalibur H20, there's a link for purchase in the description, along with a coupon code to save you some money. As always, guys, super thanks for watching, and good lucks.